Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you how I make this little quadcopter here from DJI into a drone that follows you everywhere. Let's get started.
This is the component diagram for this project. So we will have a machine learning framework, DJI Tello, so sensor module, command module, video module that will communicate to Tello. And we also need a logging system, control system, and state machine inside this Python backend to assemble and stitch them together. So let's see at first DJI Tello here. So it's from DJI and combination with Rise company. So here's the basic information that we can see. Here's the Tello, very small quadcopter, but it's not micro, but it's small. Yeah, but not much information from this website, and the price is just $99, which is for me affordable since it got some nice SDK for our future project. So you can check out the Rise website for Tello details. Yeah, feel the fun. It has like a 13-minute 100 meter range, 720p cameras, and two antennas. It has Intel processor, Intel 14 core processor, collision detection, payload weight is just 80 gram, if quite lightweight. And this collision detection is quite nice actually, when it can detect a collision and it will shut off the motor, so you don't have like overrun the motor and damage the motor if you collide into something. All right. It also have a vision projection system. This is technology getting from a DJI. It also have a mobile scratch programming. I'm not sure about programming simulator, but I'm more interested using Python to interact and control this Tello movement. So, okay, let's see on the download pages. You can go to Tello SDK, and then yeah, you just scroll down a bit. This one is version 1.3. Yeah, so you can communicate with Tello using this IP address and that port. This for send command and receive a response. So it also have a Tello state where you can stream the sensor, all the sensor in Tello, barometer, pressure sensor. Yeah, it's same, right? Clock sensor, battery percentage, Wi-Fi strength, you can get from here. You also can stream video from Tello using this IP address and that port number. Yeah, so here is some basic information. For example, to take off and land, it just send this UDP command. Then that's a specific response that it will return, either okay or error. Here's some more information to control the Tello, like left, right. Okay, so the SDK is very plain and simple, but the best thing is it communicates using UDP, which is not limited to any. So I'm using YOLO Darknet from Alexi AB, but originally it been developed by PG Ready. I'm not sure what is the real name, but you can check out the repository here. So I start using this since 2017, if I remember correctly. But the repository here seems not updated recently, so I'm just using Alexi AB, which has more decent update and commit. And it also have a pretty good tools and pretty good quick start guide for anyone to start using YOLO. So what do you expect in YOLO? So if you see here, YOLO capable to detect multiple objects, actually up to 9,000 objects. In one image in real time. So the unique selling point is fast. So yeah, if you can see, this is not the speed up video, it's the actual video. You can try this out to believe, okay? So yeah, it able to detect the object that we have been trained on. Let's say we train to detect a car, so it will detect a car. And here's some comparison with other model like a SSD. So mean average precision, FPS, frame per second. So even though the mean average precision is high, but if the FPS is low, it's maybe not much usage into actual real-time solution. So we might go for me, I'm more interested in YOLO V3 Tiny. So it has quite moderate mean average precision, but the FPS is 220, which is, it is recommended we using this model to train if we have a low-end GPU. For me, like I have GTX 1050, so I'm using this model to train. It working really well. So here I create Tello command.py, a Python script to communicate with Tello to send command to Tello using UDP. So just import the socket, bind the socket using sock dgram, and then set the Tello address to 192.168.10.1 as inside documentation, and send the command to port 8889. And then the sock bind, that then 9000 port is the to receive back the command, the response from Tello. And if we detect end in message, so we will close the UDP since it already end message opening to Tello. And then we encode the message and then send to Tello. And if any exception happen, we will close the socket and break from the while loop. It's plain simple. And just print message what I'm writing. So if I test, write test, it display test. So let's try on actual Tello. Okay. To enter the SDK, we need to send a command. And then we can send another command like take off. Yep. It's working. Plain and simple. And then we land. Land. Okay. Alright, then we create a Tello state.py, a Python script to receive a sensor state from Tello. We just copy and paste here the socket, but change the port into 8890. And then actually this NAS. Then bind the socket to 8890. Receive from the UDP and print the decoded data. If any error happen, then we just print the error and break, plain and simple. Then try run it. So connect to Tello, run the Python command, and then run this Tello state command. Then yeah, all the sensor information is streamed. Now we create tello-stream.py, a Python script to stream the video frame from Tello. So we capture at UDP port 11111, while true we will read frame from Tello using OpenCV to show the frames. And if any exception happen, destroy all windows and break. So to start streaming the video from Tello, we send a command and send the stream on command to enable the stream on. Yep, it's working. You can see my face. Now let's create a Tello AI for YOLO Darknet. Let's download from Alexi AB repository and then paste into this folder. Make sure we install LabelImg. This will be used to annotate our image later on. Then create a new folder training. I would like to put all my dataset and configuration for the training inside the training folder. Download the pre-train weight from this website, AlexTAB. YOLO V3 Tiny, convolutional 0.11. And then send to weight folder. So from here we can use this for training. And then copy coco.data, for example. We will alter this file later on to suit our usage. Create a train.txt and test.txt file. Okay. Change the path to the train.txt and test.txt file. Update the names, the label names. So I will use tello.names here. And the backup is the backup folder. When the training is reached certain limit, like 1,000 iteration, 2,000 iteration, it will save, then create a data set. Here I will put all my image and also label inside here. This, for example, some of the image has my face, some of the image does not. Then open label image. The first argument is the path to the image folder, and the second is the pass to the classes.txt folder. So that's where we keep our label. It's a reference. Okay, I don't remember if Pascal or Vogue, so just try first. Great, then just check if the output is XML, means it is Pascal VOC format, but I don't want that. I need a YOLO format. There you go. Okay, so just next iterate the image and label whenever I see my face. If there's no face, just create a empty or placeholder txt file to keep YOLO happy, and then we can start training. Oh yeah, before that we need to compile the darknet. Yeah, I changed the darknet configuration to use GPU, CUDNN, OpenCV, and this configuration is depend on you. If you don't have a GPU or you don't have a CUDA enabled, don't have the CUDNN installed. For that, we need to copy out all the image paths into the train.txt and test.txt. This to let YOLO know which dataset for training and which dataset for validation. Usually, I split it to 80% for training and 20% for dataset, but you can choose which ratio best for you. Set the path to data, path to the configuration that we're going to use, and then the pre-train weight. Yeah, we need to change batch to 1 for training, change the classes to 1 since we only have one class to detect. And for the filter, there's a formula there, which is how many class do you have plus 5 and times with 3 layer of YOLO. And then CUDA out of memory, when you face this, just change the subdivision to 8, increase it by 8. If not enough by 8, then go up to 16, 32, and so on. Okay, now it's training, but since we have 8 images here, for sure it will not train properly. So I just copy out my train model that using 500 images, then copy out to folder training, paste here, and then start detecting. For the detector demo, train, put the configuration, and there you go. The detection is quite good and fast. If I cover some of my face, it still know it is me.
So how detection from machine learning framework I use to control the movement of Tello to track the face? So the concept is very straightforward. Let me draw it for you. For example, if this is the frame that our Tello camera sees, like for example 720 times 480 pixels, then the detection box, let's say my face is here, so I'm just calculating the offset of the Bazley's face detection bounding box with the center point of the frame. So from there I can get like a 20 pixel offset from width and 10 pixel offset from height. So from there, so my Tello is from here, let's say, and imagine this is the frame that Tello see from the camera. So from then I control the Tello to move to this direction or moving forward.
So I hope you enjoyed this video. I put all the links to the source code in the description below for your reference. So till next time, bye.